गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड केमिकल बॉन्डिंग एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी शैल लर्न अबाउट द एटॉमिक मॉडल दैट इज द अरेंजमेंट्स ऑफ द सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रोटॉन न्यूट्रॉन इनसाइड एन एटम. Okay, next we'll learn octet rule, reason for chemical activity of an atom, electronic distribution in the orbits, 2n square rule, isotopes, isotone, isobars. Next we'll learn about chemical bond and the types of chemical bond like electrovalent, covalent, coordinate bond. And how the compounds are formed by these bonds, whether it is forming by sharing of electron or by transference of electron, that we will discuss in this chapter. So first we will discuss the Dalton's atomic theory. All of you know that in the year of 1808, Sir John Dalton proposed his popular atomic theory that is called Dalton's atomic theory. And according to this theory, atoms are indivisible particles. That means atoms cannot be divided. And atoms can neither be created nor be destroyed. Later in the year of 1897, Sir J.J. Thomson discovers the electron and propose that atoms can be split and will get electrons from an atom. Electrons are very tiny subatomic particles, present inside atom. Later, E. Goldstein, a German scientist, discovered protons from atoms in the year of 1909. And next in the year of 1932, James Chadwick discovered neutrons. And these electron, proton, neutron, these are called fundamental particles, or we can tell subatomic particles. Hope you can understand. Now I am coming to your syllabus. First is definition of an atom. All of you know that definition of atom and molecule and their difference. So you will tell in definition that an atom is the smallest particle of an element that exhibits all the properties of that element. And it may or may not exist independently but takes part in every chemical reaction. Next we will discuss the discovery of electron. William Crookes, a British scientist, observe that gases at very high voltage around 10,000 volt and at very low pressure, that is 0.01 mmHg, gases becomes very good conductor of electricity. But in general case, that means when we are applying less voltage, in a discharge tube or the pressure is high, it will not be a very good conductor. And he found that cathode rays travel from cathode to anode in a discharge tube. So here one diagram is there. So this diagram is a discharge tube. Here this negative part of the voltage, that high voltage you have applied 10,000, negative part you are applying to this electrode, that is called cathode. And here positive part is attached, this is called anode. And inside there is a gas at very low pressure, that is 0.01 mmHg, and we are applying 10,000 voltage here, very high voltage. Then what will happen? Inside the gas will ionize and one ray will go from this cathode to anode. And these rays are called cathode ray. And here one vacuum pump is there, to reduce the pressure. Hope you can understand. So by using this discharge tube, the cathode rays were discovered by William Crookes. Okay. Later, Sir J.J. Thomson studied the characteristics and the constituents of these cathode rays. Okay. And you will be very much wonder, okay, to know about that. Seven students of Sir J.J. Thomson, okay, won Nobel Prize in chemistry or physics. Okay. So, in this way, their electrons are discovered. And first, that E by M ratio, charge by mass ratio, was calculated by Sir J.J. Thomson. Okay. And later, Millikan, by world of experiment, find out the charge of electron. And finally, we'll get the mass of electron. In this way, electrons are discovered. Next, we'll discuss the properties of cathode ray. These rays are traveling in a straight line. Okay. Here, positive part is given. Okay. As these are the negative particles. Okay. They will be attracted by this positive electron. Hope you can understand. And these rays are attracted by the positive electric field. And because they are negatively charged particles. Cathode rays are deflected by magnetic field and cast a shadow, okay, of the object placed in their path. So here if we place a one object, okay, definitely here you will get the shadow of that particular object. Next, these rays can easily penetrate through matter, okay, and they cause ionization of the gas through which they pass, okay. Actually, inside there is some gas at very low pressure. And because of ionization of gas, okay, electrons are forming, okay. And if we keep a, or if we place a metal, okay, in the path of this cathode ray, and this metal will be heated, okay. So cathode rays can heat the metallic object if it is placed in its path. But when cathode rays heat a metal-like tungstens, okay, X-ray also produced. So, X-ray will be produced. Hope you can understand. Next, we will discuss the conclusion of this J.J. Thomson's, okay, Sir J.J. Thomson's experiment, okay, that cathode rays are negatively charged particles that are known as what? Electrons. And these cathode rays, okay, are independent of the nature of the gas. Whatever gas we can take, but the in the discharge tube, okay, we will get the same thing, same cathode rays we will get, okay. That means electrons ray, okay, we will get. An electron is the highest, electron is the lightest, okay, particle. If you consider proton, if you consider neutron, okay, one electron is 1840 times lighter than the mass of an hydrogen atom. Hope you can understand. And if you calculate the mass, that will be 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 28 gram, or 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg, okay, in SI unit. Now, absolute change of an electron, okay, sorry, absolute charge, absolute charge of an electron, okay, calculated by Waldorf experiment of Millikan, by Millikan, okay, he was also a very good scientist, okay. And the atomic charge was, here I am writing, minus 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Hope you can understand. And if we write in electrostatic unit, it will be minus 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 10 ES, electrostatic unit. Okay. Now this charge, that is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, has been found that this is the smallest, okay, charge of any particle, and this indicates that the electrons has one unit negative charge, that is minus 1, and these negatively charged particles are an integral part of all atoms, okay. That means electrons are present in each type of atom, okay. Whatever you can take, everywhere there is electron. Hope you can understand. And electrons are also extremely small. If you consider the size of an atom, it will be the angstrom level, that is 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter. But the size of the electron, okay, if I tell in the SI unit, that is meter, it will be 1 into 10 to the power minus 15. So radius of an electron will be around the order 1 into 10 to the power minus 15. So you can able to understand that how tiny it is. Okay. Now by different types of high resolution spectroscopy, okay, and different types of modern technique, we get the cloud of electron, okay, we get the picture of cloud of electrons, okay. Next we will go to the discovery of protons. Goldstein noticed a set of rays traveling in opposite direction of the cathode rays in discharge tube. He named them as canal rays, okay, that pass through the holes in the cathode. And these rays are called anode rays. Here one diagram is drawn. So here what we have used, one perforated cathode is used. Okay. So definitely one ray is going from cathode to anode, that is called cathode rays. And because of ionization of gas, that positive cations will be also formed. So that will go the opposite direction of this cathode ray. So these rays. So these type of rays are anode rays. Here also we are applying high voltage, and gases are at very low pressure, but definitely the anode rays will depend on the nature of the gas. Cathode ray is not depending on the nature of the gas, but anode ray is depending on the nature of the gas. Hope you can understand. So in this way, by analyzing these anode rays, okay, protons are discovered. Now we'll discuss the properties of an anode rays, okay. So anode rays travel in a straight line. The electric charge on these rays or particles is always positive. The amount of the positive charge of the positive rays particles depends upon the nature of the gas taken in the discharge tube. And the positive charge of any particle was found to be a multiple of this charge, that is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. In case of electron, we are writing negative, but in case of proton, only one, when hydrogen is there, so then it will be plus. Hope you can understand. And the mass of the particles, okay, was the same as the atomic mass of the particular gas in the discharge tube. And these particles are affected by the electric field and magnetic field, just in the opposite direction. So this anode ray, if you keep a negative plate, that in negative plate it will be attracted. Where in cathode rays, okay, that will be attracted by the positive electric field, okay, or positive plate. Next we'll discuss the characteristics of proton. Proton is a positively charged particle having the charge, that is 1.602 plus, okay, 1.602 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And the relative charge of a proton will consider as plus 1, okay, unit charge, plus 1 unit charge. And mass of proton you will get, that will be, if you calculate, you will get that is 1.672 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram, okay, or in kg it will be 1.672 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. Now what is the relative mass, okay? Relative mass of proton will be 1 mu, the AMU indicates that atomic mass unit, which is almost 1840 times than the mass of electron. That means a proton is heavier, okay, in mass compared to the mass of electron. And atoms are electrically neutral, okay. And if you calculate the number of proton and number of electrons, what you will find that always the number of protons are equal to the number of electrons, okay. So total charge of proton and total charge of electron are balancing each other, okay. But if we add some electron to a particular atom, what will happen? Okay, it will become negatively charged ions, that is called anion. But if an atom loses some electron, okay, then it will become positively charged, okay, that we can tell as cation, okay. So in this way, okay, we have finished or complete the discussion of discovery of electron and proton. And next day we will discuss the scattering experiment by Rutherford and the Rutherford atomic model. Then we will discuss the discovery of neutron. Then we will discuss why Rutherford model is not accepted, what are the drawbacks of the Rutherford model, and finally we will discuss the Bohr's atomic model, okay, that is accepted, very much accepted, okay. So today up to this, thank you.